Hello everyone, welcome to Aptly Place Academy for Civil Services. Today I'll be discussing a special topic, that is Elephant Corridor in Odisha. This topic is very much relevant for your current affairs and this will help you out in prelims and mains examination. So Elephant Corridor was there in the news, and talking about the importance, it become very significant for prelims examination, being civil service examination combined for forest services and civil services. This become very relevant. So they can ask you a mains question on this as well. So we'll understand the dimension of this topic that will help you both in the prelims and mains. So these are the dimensions that I'll be covering. The first would be National Green Tribunal Directives. The second is, what is elephant corridors? The third, what are the advantages of protecting the corridor? And the conservation status of the Indian elephant. And the last would be the initiative for the conservation of elephants. What are the government initiatives that they have taken? So we'll be covering these dimension on the session. So stay tuned till end of this video so that you can understand what is exactly elephant corridor and how this is going to help for the betterment of the elephants. So in the recent verdict, the NGT, that is National Green Tribunal, they have directed the Odisha government to notify the proposed corridor for the free movement of elephant in the state. Why this order has come with the NGT? Because Odisha government in 2010 has already identified 14 corridor to be notified for the safe movement of elephant. Odisha government in 2010 mein hi notify kiya tha ki kuch aise corridor hain, important 14 corridor hain jo ki dedicatedly elephant ke liye rakhe jayenge. But proposal bahut lambi delay hui. The proposal has been pending delay for a long time. And you can see from 2010, we are in 2020. So almost it has been delayed by 10 years. The reason being, NGT has taken the decision and NGT had directed the Odisha government to propose it further because the free movement of elephant is very important in the ecosystem. Now talking about the NGT tribunal directives, NGT ne kya kaha hai apne directives mein. So NGT had directed the Odisha government to prepare an action plan within 3 months toward identifying the 14 elephant corridor. Apne order mein NGT ne ye clear kiya hai ki you will be provided with 3 month duration to prepare an action plan that how you gonna execute the 14 identified elephant corridor that was previously identified by the Odisha government in 2010. Now this would provide stress-free migration to the jumbos. Jumbos here means elephant and the entire family. The small, basically elephant are not very, the sizes or the ages is not that high. So the jumbos from on one habitation to another habitation would be taken into the consideration. And the state government has proposed 14 corridors stretching from a total area of 870 kilometers, that is square kilometer, having a length of 420 kilometers. So it's a long stretch covering 14 corridors, right? So this number is again important. If you are appearing for any other state PCS examination, they can ask you the number as well. Now, despite passing of the several years, no tangible progress has been made by the government proposal. Abhi tak koi saidhantik kaam nahi kiya gaya, bhutal agar bole, jameeni sar pe bahut saare aise kaam nahi kiya gaya. So it is very important that there should be concrete and practical decision that has to be taken by the Odisha government. Now, what is elephant corridor? To be precise, we'll be also discussing what is elephant corridor, how this was benefiting to the overall population of the elephants. So elephant corridor is a narrow strip of land that connect two habitat of the elephants. They are very crucial to reduce the animal fatalities due to the accident and the other reason, because we have seen many time in the news, basically on the railway tracks and the other parts, that elephant have been reported dead, right? And movement of the elephant keeps in enhancing the survival species for the birth rate. So it is equally important for the government of India and the government of other state government that they should take a note that elephant population has to be there, and at the same time they should do something so that they could enhance their survival and the birth rate. Now talking about the fragmentation of the forest, it make it more important to preserve the migratory corridor. Aise jo migratory corridor hai jahan pe aksar elephant ki movement hoti hai, usko preserve rakhna, and at the same time protecting that corridor would be the pivotal for state governments. Now total 88 elephant corridor have been identified by the Wildlife Trust of India and National Elephant Corridor Project. This is a project by Government of India to make a hassle-free movement of the elephant, and at the same time वहाँ पे किसी भी तरह से fatalities ना हो, और जो fatalities खास करके accident की अगर मैं बात करूँ तो उसको रोका जा सके. What are the advantages of protecting the corridor? बात करें अगर movement की, तो movement is very essential to ensure their population are genetically viable. So this is a point that you can be asked in the examination. The first and foremost would be to ensure their population are genetically viable. The second would be that it will help to regenerate the forest on which the species including tiger depend. And the third, it will provide protection for nearly 40% of the elephant reserve that are vulnerable. I'll tell you what are the IUCN status of the elephant as well. And they are not within the protected area or sanctuaries, right? So it is very important that the protected areas, the sanctuaries, where actually their movement should be, where they should be actually be kept, is not being taken care. This is why the corridor has been proposed by the NGT. Now the alternative route would result in decreasing the human animal conflict. जो एलिफेंट और ह्यूमन के बीच में जो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट है उसको भी बहुत हद तक कम करने में मदद मिलेगी इन कॉरिडोर्स के थ्रू. नाउ व्हाट इज द कंजर्वेशन स्टेटस ऑफ इंडियन एलिफेंट, बिकॉज इफ यू आर गोइंग टू द प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन क्वेश्चंस यू कैन सी दैट दे हैव ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड द IUCN स्टेटस ऑफ वेरियस स्पीसीज. सो दिस बिकम वेरी रेलेवेंट दैट यू नो व्हाट इज द स्टेटस ऑफ द इंडियन एलिफेंट्स. So elephants are the keystone species. They are protected under Wildlife Protection Act 1972 and they are covered under Schedule 1. And the IUCN status is endangered. And talking about the sites, they are under Appendix 1. So these four are very crucial and very important information that you have to learn because they can be a very factual question in the prelims. Now in 2010, the government has declared elephant as the national heritage and the element of the country, right? So talking about the government of India, they have declared elephant as a national heritage animal of the country, and a proposed National Elephant Conservation Authority, that is NECA, on the line of NTCA, that is National Tiger Conservation Authority, jaise India mein exist karti hai, us tarah se प्रपोज किया गया था नेशनल एलिफेंट कंजर्वेशन अथॉरिटी बनाने के लिए भी, दैट हैड बीन कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड बाय अमेंडिंग द वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट ऑफ 1972. मोस्ट ऑफ द एनिमल दैट आर इंडेंजर्ड और वल्नरेबल आर प्रोटेक्टेड बाय द वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट ऑफ 1972. नाउ कमिंग टू द इनिशिएटिव्स फॉर द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एलिफेंट दैट गवर्नमेंट हैज टेकन एंड सम सक्सेसफुल इनिशिएटिव्स. सी वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ इनिशिएटिव्स टेकन फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ एलिफेंट्स, but I'll be discussing few which is more relevant in present context. So Project Elephant, this was a central sponsor scheme launched in 1992 for the protection of elephant, their habitat and corridors, and it seeks to address the issues of human wildlife conflict and the welfare of domesticated elephants. The second most important initiative by the government is Gaj Yatra. Gaj Yatra is a national wide campaign to protect the elephant. It was launched on the occasion of World Elephant Day in 2017. So how many of you know what is World Elephant Day? Do let me know in the comment section down below. And this is all about the Gaj Yatra. And this is a infographic which will help you understand about finding the territory. So you can see the state with the highest population, Karnataka being the number like 6049, followed by Assam, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Odisha. And reporting jumbos for the first time would be Manipur, Mizoram. The highest number is in South Bengal, Nicobar and Bihar, right? And these are the comparison of the state and their county. So you can pause this video and you can see the infographic which state has the maximum population estimate, and these estimate are according to the census 2017, right? So this was all about the elephant corridor which was recently proposed in Odisha and the NGT directive with regards to land only. If you are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe Aptiplace Academy for Civil Service on YouTube. And if you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. If you have any other concern, do let us know. We'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.